Hello, Twitch. So I'm still a little bit sick, but Epi is going to run a game. We are going to be streaming it. You'll have somewhat updated cam for me as I try and deal with being sick. So let's take us over to Epi and the players. Hello, Epi and the players.
Hello.
Hey.
Hello, Sev and Twitch.
Hi, hi.
So,
hi, Twitch.
You all somehow got wind of a smuggler. Be it Kirk passing the information to you, or you overhear Kirk passing the information to someone. You all banded together to go off and find the smuggler. You reach his last known location, and lo and behold, he's there, but he's already prepped for a fight. What you know about the smuggler is he was known to smuggle elven artifacts. He came over from Lyca. He seems to be on the run from something. You're unsure of what. And, you literally walk into the middle of him and his friends with their weapons drawn, looking very, very angry. So, before we go any further, let's have everyone introduce their characters. Let's start with Tree. Tree, let's have you introduce your character.
Who?
Tree. You're on mute. Tree.
Ah, he has to type.
Ah, you have to type? Okay. Well, skipping over that, let's go to Peppers. Peppers, you introduce your character.
Okay, my character's name is WC Shaver. Well, it's Will Thrill Char Shaver. I mean, Charfall Shaver, but, you know, if you could shorten it as you please. He is a clothing trader. Well, he is a aspiring clothing trader on a journey to find the world's most loved trends in clothing and take some notes on it. Not much really known about him, but he's from a trading guild, and he's an arcane trickster rogue. Very glam rock. The end.
Just know anything about it is glam rock. There's nothing else.
There's more.
Okay, so, Celion, you introduce your character.
My character is Setsuna Miyatoshi. And she is more or less a wandering samurai. She can no longer go back to her home. There are reasons for that. But to simplify it, she's a fugitive. Or it's a complicated kind of fugitive. So she's more or less settled down into Penrith, and yeah, that's about it. She's a fighter. So, there you go. Go crazy.
Starry, yeah. I know you can talk. You
yes, I can.
Card.
I am Lilaea Swickliver. I have been wondering for quite some time. Ever since my tribe was decimated by a raid from the other tribe, a rival tribe of ours, and I heard wind of a golden hunt. Because I'm a huntress, I was very interested and made my way to Penrith, and here I am.
Hey, Aichan, who are you playing?
Hi everyone, I'm Arteria Pendragon. Penrith native, and I'm a paladin of court. If I see bad things happen, I make sure everything is in my power to stop that bad thing from happening. So don't be a bad person, otherwise I will remember you.
Let's see who's left. I think I got everyone. Fallen, who are you playing today?
Fallen's not important, says the mod.
I had to recount because last person there was Sev, so.
Okay. Fallen?
I think he might be typing also. Fallen? Oh, yeah, you've been talking? We can't hear you, man. Disconnect and reconnect.
Is that better?
That's better.
Alrighty. I'm playing Ren Stormraven, who had a dark beginning with family that were students of the dark arts. His parents decided to try to, while he was but a child, summon a demonic creature. It ended up bonding itself to him, so they decided, hey, we're going to cover our own backs and turn him over to the temple so that he will be eliminated. Well, the entity decided to help him to free himself. He became a sailor and a student of magic. And he has been journeying, which led him to find, while at working as a sailor, finding his way to Penrith, trying to make a better understanding of his magic capabilities. And he just tries to introduce himself more as just a spellcaster with air quotes instead of the fact that he is actually a warlock.
So, you make your journey to a small river near the forest. It's wouldn't call it a river, more of a stream, but it's there. And lo and behold, you see the group of smugglers. They all look a little bit worse for wear. In fact, they're looking very jumpy right now. And as I move you all to the map, you can see the map, correct, and your tokens?
Quite.
Let's see.
You can also see yourselves?
Yep.
Okay. You can also see initiative, correct?
Yes.
I'm going to need you all to roll initiative.
Wow.
Not bad. I say, looking at either Chan's roll and Ren's roll.
So everyone's rolled? Okay, I can reorder this. Sending, and we have a Will up first. They know you're coming. A quick question. Tree.
Yeah.
Has Aquata taken care of that shrine she was sent to take care of?
Yep.
God damn it, I'm trying to find the. There we go. Okay. Just making sure, because if she hasn't, her powers would be halved right now.
Well, goody. I'm glad that we avoided that.
So, Will.
Alright, Do they seem like they're still capable of being negotiated with? Just by looking at them?
They look like they're ready to fight. They're aggressive.
Okay, so I'm going to do what any great rogue does and run for the bushes.
Flee and cower.
And I ready an attack for if things go wrong. I mean, I ready the rest of my action for if things go wrong.
Yeah. Oh. You can ready an attack. You won't have any movement.
Okay. I'm okay with that.
Right. Whose turn is it next? It is Setsuna.
Okay. So we've basically just walked into...
You've walked into a fight.
Yeah, okay. Then... quick and easy, she's going to walk over here. And engage.
Okay. Oh, you're getting married. That's nice. I mean, bandits are
one thing. It took her so long. She's just very happy she finally found someone.
Roll me your attacks.
Yes.
That hits.
Yeah. Sweet.
Yeah, that hits. He is still up.
Okay.
That hits.
Oh, okay. To clarify, basically roll two twice.
Woo! Yep, and he's dead.
Alright.
Okay,
so with that ready my attack?
Sure.
Okay. Oh crap, my mouse is acting up. Okay. I'll shoot this guy. And use my short bow.
Okay. Oh, shit.
Yes.
One sec. There we go. Accidentally closed the turn order. You rolled a 20. Yeah, that hits.
Okay. Do I get sneak attack?
Yeah.
Oh, cool. That's a pretty bad sneak attack roll. Oh well. And
yeah, he's dead.
Yeah, yeah.
You literally just kill this guy. Like, he has a chunk missing out of him. He's like falls to the ground, clutching at his neck as you shot out a chunk of his neck and blood spurts everywhere.
I killed a man. Okay.
A name I'm going to have serious trouble trying to pronounce, so I'm going to call you Leela.
Just call her Leia, if it... like, Princess Leia. She's not a princess, but... yeah, do that. Okay, I'm going to go... there. Yeah. And... shot at this guy with Lamba. I don't think I get a double attack yet.
That hits. What level are you? Six.
I'm three each.
Then no, you don't.
Yeah, so that. And I will use my bonus action to hide.
You're a rogue, right?
Yes, I am a rogue ranger hybrid.
What level do you get cunning action?
Two, I think.
Mm-hmm. Second. Okay, so.
See?
You use your... Roll me stealth.
Okay, hold on.
Okay, so it's now the bandit captain's turn. And he's going to see that there's a band of adventurers come running up. And they're basically tearing his men to pieces. And he's going to shout at you, like, how do I put this? You damn fools! And he's going to actually, instead of attacking, he's going to make a break for it. So.
Wait, where is he?
Oh, there. 10. 15. 20. 25. 30, and because he didn't use his action, 5, 10, 15, 20, he gets over here. So, that's his turn. And I just did it again. Next, it's the bandit's turn, or his minions. And... we have one running up here. And one running up here.
Okay.
And one running up here. Let's see. 5, 10, 15. Gonna move him over to the side because he's just in the way. And this guy behind him. Is it behind him? Not under. Doing this one-handed is a pain in the arse. Just saying this now. And he left. Oh, there's this guy over here. If it will let me click it. So, this guy pops up here, drops a bow, guy down here, nearly missed him. This guy pops up here, also drawing a bow. So, I'll go with the archers first, and then move to the actual attacks. So, first ranged attack is on you, Sal. Okay. Does that hit you? What is it? It's a 7. So I'm guessing a 7 doesn't hit you. Celion?
I think a 7 should probably not hit because I think natural is 10.
Yeah, so he misses, and it's auto rolling, so I'm just gonna change that somehow. Don't auto roll. Damn it. And the next one is probably going to be on you, Ren. Sorry. I'm guessing a five misses.
Ren just watches the crossbow bolt go right past him. Just, what was that?
The two bandits next to Ren start swinging.
And 21 both hits, and Ren is going to be able to use Hellish Rebuke.
Awesome. So first we roll their damage. So 10, and then you do your Hellish Rebuke. Is it a dex save or?
Dex.
Since there's only two of them, I'll make two dex saves. They both pass. So they take half damage. So, five. But, yeah, no, you've seriously hurt them with that. They look pretty cut up. If it would let me click on stuff. Rage. So, and there's two more attacks on. Setsuna? Well, one more attack.
Nope.
And I'm guessing it's six misses. Yeah, great. Okay, so it's now.
Actually, wait. Since that failed to attack me, can I use Riposte?
Is it whenever someone misses you?
Correct.
Then yes, you can. So he takes 8
that
damage.
Better not hit. No, it has to hit. Okay, good. I'm glad I don't have disadvantage.
Okay, so do you roll normal damage as well on top of that?
Yes. That was not meant to be a perception roll, but that is 20 damage.
Yeah, you literally slice this guy in half, as he swings and misses. You just turn your sword sideways and step forward, cutting him half in the middle. His torso sliding one way, his hips sliding another.
Yeah, it slides down off of his arm and then just falls to the ground as blood smatters. Place. Yes.
Okay, Quada. Which I've just realized I'm going to have to read roll 20, and I'm waiting for it to catch up with me.
Okay, she is doing Sacred Flame on the one above Ren with ADC 17 dex save.
Okay. One second. Bandit. Deck save!
14 damage.
And he fails. You literally burn this guy alive. You click your fingers or whatever you do to make the sacred flame. It's kind of weird from a mermaid flame. But anyways, you kind of hold out your hands and this guy suddenly bursts into flames from the inside out. And they're all radiant and whatnot, and he falls to his knees dead, leaving his friend standing there looking absolutely terrified. And
that's it.
It is now their mage's turn, which is going to be fun.
Oh, yes, it may.
Let's see. What spells can I throw at you?
When the DM's like, what spells to try?
Pretty much. Ooh, hang on. I have to check something, because I think they have a very nasty one. Oh, yes, they have very nasty spells. You can tell that the muscle of the group is more likely the spellcasters than the actual muscle.
We figured, knowing spellcasters.
So, there is going to be, one of them is going to cast Fireball. And there's a nice little grouping of people right here.
Hey, Epi, counterspell.
Sure. Where are you? Yeah, no reaction.
Okay.
So, I'm going to cast it here. And that's going to hit all but Will.
Dex save? So,
do I have to dex save?
One sec. I'm just going to click the button that does the spell, so you know what you're doing. And Fireball.
Where is it?
One sec. You're in the aura. Everyone but Will's in the aura, based on the radius of effect. It's just taking some time to load, like Roll 20 does on me, which bugs me to no end. Still waiting for it to come true. One second. Shakes Roll 20. And I think it went true.
Not seen it.
Click send.
There it is.
There it goes.
There it is.
DC 14 sec save. Got it.
So, Ren passes and takes half damage. You pass. Aquata fails.
Plus 4.
You pass.
Yeah, order. Aura. So, add the aura for Arturian.
Oh, wait. Hang on. Quata gets the aura, which is plus 4. She still fails, I believe. Yeah, 13. So everyone but Quata passes. So Quata, you take 33 fireball.
Ow.
Everyone else takes 16. Yeah. 16. So, The second guy, because there's two of them,
of course,
is going to cast if I could bring up the spell description, I would. It would be great. It would be beautiful. He is, because I don't know what the others do, he's also going to cast a fireball in the same spot. Because, why not? It worked well last time.
I can't do acrobatics or anything on that, can I? No, no.
Nope, no. Nope. You just gotta take it like a man. Or a woman, in your case.
Can I have advantage?
You now have disadvantage.
Same thing at this point.
Be glad I could be casting it at higher levels.
Are you re-rolling it again, or are we just doing disable the build?
No, this is the second one. So I'm re-rolling it. So it could be higher, it could be lower damage.
Oh wait, it's a deck save. Not a... Whoops, that's the wrong one. Should I do that again?
Do you have proficiency? You passed it anyways, so...
I did?
Last time.
This
time it's a dexterity save. So proficiency just Aquata passes this time, so she only takes half. Aichan, you fail. Let's have a look. With proficiency. Do you have proficiency in dex saves? Stop.
Me?
Yeah.
No.
Dang.
That was just me wondering. Could I somehow get a reroll out of this?
No, you don't get a reroll. So you take full damage. Everyone. Hang on. Ren, did you roll? Did. So both Sal and Ren have rolled. Am I missing someone?
No, that's it. Will is out of the threat range.
Oh yeah, Will is out of the threat range.
I've been red boxed. A couple seconds.
You all take, those who have passed take 14. Those who fail take 28. Arturia, it is your turn.
Have her move here. She's gonna look at the bandit captain. And she's gonna go ahead and cast command on him. Save DC of 16.
Okay, what? What's the save?
It's the, here.
Is it wisdom?
Yeah, it's a wisdom save, and it's a DC save of 16. What she's gonna command is, approach.
So So he feels that fails that save. He looks at you, and then he suddenly walks off in a different direction.
She said approach.
Yeah. He wasn't running from you.
Okay, the command was to approach me, though.
Yeah, no, but the wording of command is how the DM determines, correct? Okay, then on his turn, he'll move towards her.
And then, bonus action, Arteria will drink a potion. Geo's 14. That ends my turn.
Ren, it is now your turn.
Woohoo! Ren is going to make use of 5th level Scorching Ray. It'll be 6 bolts. And he's going to start. Can you hear me?
Could you post up the spell description, please?
Yep, 1 second.
Also, it's for me. I'm sorry. I just do it this way. Don't say I start here and I move that way. Tell me how many bolts you use on one character, how many bolts you use on the other one. And then we will roll them.
No problem.
So, how many are you using where?
I'm going to do 2 against this guy right here. And okay. The remaining 4 is being launched towards the leader.
The leader, who is well out of your line of sight.
I have a range of 240 feet and I have Spell Sniper.
Yeah, but he is literally, if you were to follow your line of sight, he is behind a tree. Unless you can bend spells around solid objects.
I don't have Meta Magic, so I guess I'll send 2 towards each of the spellcasters.
Okay. And roll me the 2 on the guy closest to you. So, first one hits, roll me on the second one. This first roll me damage on the first one. Okay, so 4 damage. Now roll me damage on the second one. And 7. Victoria, you take 7 damage as you get hit by a stray Scorching Ray. Now,
4 more heading your way.
Yeah, there's 4 more heading your way. So, roll me the first 2 on the left. 16 and 28. Pretty sure they hit. 1 sec. Just taking the token. Let's see. Yeah, they hit. So 5 and 8. And then the next two. They both hit, roll me damage. Nice damage.
And as my bonus, I am going to drink one of my greater healing potions.
Okay then. And that is your turn, correct? Okay. So, Will, it's your turn.
Okay, I'm going to dash over to the mages, and I'm going to cast...
What's your movement speed?
This is a dash, sorry.
Yeah, a dash, you have your movement, and then you have your dash speed.
That's a 60, sorry.
Okay.
My dash speed is 60.
You do realize you have to run around the trees as well. You can't just run straight through them.
Oh, okay. Then could I recon all that? Okay. I'm going to move to this tree right here, and I'm going to sneak.
Did you measure out how far that is?
That is less than 60. That is less than 30. Let's see. Sorry about that. Here we go. I'm going to do another bow shot then at the bandit right here. All right, sneak. Sorry.
Because you're technically right in front of him.
Oh, sorry.
True. Okay. It's also the fact that he's trying to hide right in front of a bandit.
Okay.
True.
Okay. Wait, so that was my movement. That was... Okay.
Your bonus action. You still have an action.
Okay. Then I'm going to... I'm going to shoot him then. No, actually Ray of Frost. On this guy. Oh, sorry. Ray of Frost, sorry.
And I'll give it to you.
Alright.
Sorry. Yeah, that hits. Roll damage.
Okay. And I just end my turn then. Yeah, I'm my turn, sorry.
Okay. So it is now, once Roll 20 catches up with me, I think it's Sal's turn. One sec. Am I right?
Yes.
Okay. So.
Okay. Let me see. She's not happy.
Yeah, I don't think anyone's happy right now. Also, my laptop is crashing. So, give it a moment.
Circle troubles, so it's gonna not mess with it too much.
There we go. It's back up. Okay, so. What are you up to?
Okay, let me check one thing. Probably going to start with Second Wind.
Okay. Is that your bonus action, or does it require?
If I remember correctly, I believe that's a bonus. Let me check.
Okay, just making sure it's a bonus action. So heal yourself up 12.
Already did. Oh, wait. Oh, I didn't update that. That should actually be 13. Because it's plus 7, not plus 6.
Okay, add plus 1.
Okay. Also, could you quickly show me where they did the fireball from and the range it had, if I can ask?
You were behind a tree. You know it came from above you, but unless you step out and look and see the two mages, you won't know where it came from. Did you move out, or?
Well, I wanted to know where it hit on the map.
Where it hit on the map?
How far did it, and how big it was.
It hit here, roughly, and it was 20 feet.
Ah, okay.
It was a fireball. It hit behind you.
Right, okay, so. I'll move like that. And,
you go any further, you're going to take an opportunity of attack, just so you know.
I know. I just wanted to know how far I needed to go. At least in theory.
Four. Oh.
If.
Alright.
And, let's see here. I'm going to stab him in the face. Hard. And yeah, I think I'm just gonna stab him. Hope for the best.
Okay. Well, once Roll 20 stops crashing on me, I'll let you know if how
it
things
hit.
Go.
Wait a second. Do I technically have flank?
No, she has a range weapon.
She is a rain, yeah.
Oh,
thank okay. you for that, iChat.
I'm
still not listening.
What?
No, just someone's listened about the whole you don't get advantage unless the other person has a melee weapon. Anywho,
I would have loved advantage though. He would be dead, most likely, with advantage. But neither here nor there. I'm just gonna wait for your roll 20 to reload before I check damage on that.
Okay, roll me damage.
Okay. Eight damage.
One second, gotta check his health. Oh no, he's still alive.
Okay. Then I finish him off.
Two Roll damage.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's you lop off this guy's head.
I'm having fun.
Whose turn is it now? You end your turn?
Technically I could have movement, but yeah, I think I'll move. No, I think I'm good. Yeah, I'll end my turn.
Sure, okay.
It's Leela's turn.
Leela.
Yes.
Hi, Leela.
Hi. Okay, she's gonna... This guy? Bam. Bam. And bonus action to hide again.
Okay, so you're going to attack that guy
this
twice?
Guy. No, I have one attack and sneak attack. No, not that guy, this guy.
The guy over by Ren.
The one, yeah. Ren.
Yeah. I cannot attack. I cannot do sneak. I attack twice yet. Can do sneak attack. Rain.
You could tell this guy was on death's door, and you just no mercy. Turn and twang. Mm-hmm. Arrow through the back of the head and brain matter all over Ren.
I'd like to think that the arrow just, took his head and it pinned it to the... to some rock.
You can take
in the
that,
distance.
but you know, it was still technically attached to his body. Now, it no is force. The bandit captain's turn.
Oh, I forgot to roll my stuff. Hold on.
Gotta find me the bandit captain. Yeah, he gonna make me
move
over here.
Remember, he has approach.
I know. And he's got to move over here. Say hello to Ria. And
hi.
That's his turn. There's like two bandits left, and they're looking very, very confused. So, Aturia.
What's up?
Yeah. Yeah. One second, I just gotta get a character sheet from somewhere, because I forgot to open it. Derp. So, there we go. That's not what I was looking for. Just gotta go to another lair, because plot stuffs are happening. Plot stuffs.
Plot stuff.
This other lair scares me.
Yay, we have a prisoner.
I went to the wrong lair. God damn it. Of course, my connection has to go down just as I move things to their lair.
Hello.
Ross, are you in voice chat by any chance? He's not. God damn it, Ross. One second. I've gotta go kick someone.
So how's everybody feeling?
Oh, I'm red boxed, so I feel horrible.
So am I.
What do you mean red boxed?
Artilia has a prisoner.
I finally understand what you mean by red boxed.
Yeah. Sorry about that.
It's a red box.
Well, it's more like an octagon. Oh, you know, it's still a box. It's just a less pretty box, and therefore should not be treated better.
Sorry, there's any background noise. Still on disconnect your connection, just for God damn it. Roll 20, get the finger out.
But so many fingers.
Yeah, I don't think that idea is gonna work. Since, yeah. Oh well. Are you all still getting that your connection is interrupted?
I've had to reload myself, so. But that was for a different reason.
God damn it! I don't want to refresh. That means I have to open all the stuff up again. Yeah, I had already clicked refresh when you said just wait. Why does it come back when I click refresh? Hmm?
My baby's back.
Murphy's Law.
Which one? No.
What can go wrong will go wrong. So, while we're waiting for everything to load, how is everyone? Did you like those fireballs?
Not really, but it's
okay. Much.
I'm probably gonna talk to the Vatican before I start hitting him, by the way, if I get a chance to hit him.
Yes, if you get a chance to hit him.
I say if,
And the page just crashed for me. God,
I'm so
damn
sorry,
it.
Oh, I don't think he killed off one of the bandits.
He's moving at half speed, so.
Mm-hmm. Not Will. I mean, one of the bandits that I think you moved into the tree, I think is supposed to be dead.
Yeah, no, he's one of them is dead. Just too lazy and too much of a wonky screen to put a little X on him.
Oh, sorry to hear that, Eddie.
And I am still waiting for it to come back up. God damn it.
And it just force reloaded on my screen. Refresh.
So, yes. You may notice a little surprise when you manage to get back on the screen.
Well then.
Is the bandit captain now a frost giant? No.
No, he's now a titan, and he's just stepped on you.
Okay, good.
Oh, great. Well, my character saved from his role in the round table.
What was your role in the round table, Peppers?
In I was the guy that Lancelot killed.
While we're waiting, can I talk to the bandit captain?
Sure. Why not?
Why are you here, and why? What are you running from?
Is Firefly in chat right now? We have no Firefly. Good. That means I don't have to censor it. Go fuck yourself.
She's gonna say, wrong answer. You saw what we do with your buddies. No, I think you best tell us. The dungeons are better than that, aren't they?
He spits at you.
He seems like a nice guy.
I'm not gonna talk to man, woman, ting.
She's gonna wipe the spit and go, you just followed my command.
Yeah, I've come here. Now I can fucking leave. Again, I apologize for this character's attitude, but yeah. Again, go fuck yourself.
I'm gonna say wrong answer. Death awaits you.
So what's this next lair?
We'll have to wait for it.
Yeah, no, it's not a lair per se. When you're in DM mode, you have different layers, and they're kind of like GM and map layer.
More enemies pop up immediately. Layer.
This is where all the stuff I've hidden is. Now it's coming out to bite you in the ass. I mean, what?
Oh boy.
It's loading for me. Awesome.
Jeez, such harsh language.
In life in general, how are you? Meh. Yeah. Do you have any one-shots planned later? Ooh. Am I going to die in them? Is the important question.
Yes. No. I thought Sev was also supposed to be in this one.
Nope, wow. We have Starry for this.
We gave it to Starry.
Mm-hmm.
Ah, okay.
Thank you, by the way. Very kind of you.
Your funeral.
Yeah.
I'm starting to consider that this one shot has been appropriately named, Sev.
What did you name it?
Heroes never die.
A walk in the woods.
Oh, wow. I think I remember that.
Yeah, you guys should probably remember that.
Thanks, by the way.
Starry's characters, whenever they go for a walk in the woods, have a habit of dying. So, while you're chatting to this guy, and he's basically giving you nothing but grief, you hear a roar. Shame Firefly isn't here because I get her to go rare. Out from behind some trees comes a green, scaly head.
Oh.
How fun.
We are Team Furry. I mean, what?
Ooh. That might be a thing. She thinks to herself.
Oh, that's what you're running for.
That's it.
How about we work together on this one?
I mean, it's not like they're important people. They're just low lives.
I didn't kill anyone. Just saying.
Yeah, I didn't kill anyone. And what did you say to him during that whole negotiation? We've killed your entire
friends.
Party.
And she said, you saw what we did.
Roll persuasion.
Death is not like. Would you rather have death, or would you rather?
There's no
dungeon?
Persuasion. You just.
It's death or the dungeon.
Death versus death. Yo. Why would he go to? You've kind of, yeah, you know what? No, I'm not even going to. So, this green scaly head pops its head out, looks towards the bandage, and then towards Arturia. Brings its head back, and I have I have no. Whatchamacallit's open. God damn it.
Rest in peace.
Just use your breath weapon. You know you're going to use the breath weapon.
Cha. Anyways, if only Roll 20 would be nice to me.
Can't immediately.
I love you, Roll 20. I believe in you.
Roll 20, I'm sacrificing them to the dice gods for later. There we go, it's working. It's working now.
Yes! 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 Thank you, sleep baby Jesus.
What just happened?
It rolled a 2.
It rolled in that one.
For initiative!
Where?
The dragon.
Oh, yeah. This action still goes off.
Okay.
Sorry.
Oh.
Yeah, that's my dog barking in her sleep, by the way. She is a dog.
Bailey does that too, so...
Oh, shit. I wasn't meant to click that button. Oh, well. I'm pretty sure Turia to make a dex save, because I know these guys aren't going... 30-foot cone.
Yep, that...
It's a con save.
Is it con save?
Yeah.
Oh, then it's con save. Thought it was a dex save to avoid the con.
It's +4 to con.
Yeah, con save.
+4, and I still fail. Well, guys, guess who's knocked out?
Okay.
Actually,
no, it's a
9 14.
+4. Oh, then, yeah, but I'm still, wait, so is it half then, or?
I thought it was a +5 to +4.
No, it's 9 plus 4 is 13.
Okay, my brain,
DC
my brain
14. What about the captain and the bandits?
Oh no, they auto fail.
Death saving throws.
You take 55 points of poison damage.
yeah, I only had 32 HP.
So, Arturia goes down. And so do these two over here. If I was on the right layer, God. Anyway, him over there, him over there. They're both dead.
We don't have to deal with the captain anymore. That's a good, this is not good.
And I'm going to say this now. The only two people who know Arturia is down and that there's a dragon are...
Ren and
Aquata. And it is now... Ooh, hang on. Still on a bandit's turn.
There's one.
There's one bandit left. And, you're gonna start to run. That way. And... Aquata. It is now your turn. If it... There we go. Aquata.
Yes.
You cast Beacon of Hope. Okay, that's your action.
How many people was it?
30 feet.
Oh, okay.
1 second. I'm going to put the radius up. This one, right? Yes. And aura 1. What color do you want your aura?
Let's go with green. Blue, okay.
I'll change my color.
That's
yours is down, isn't it, Arturi?
it's down, but I'm pretty sure I'm gonna get up again after her healing ward.
There you go. 30 feet radius.
Oh. Then is Arturia not within the...
I'm with
the 30 feet. Okay. Now she is. Okay. So, and then she casts Mass Healing Word.
Oh. Hi, Ross.
Good evening.
Hi, Ross.
I brought a dragon to a bandit fight.
I was summoned.
Yes. So, Arturia has gone down, Ross. And just about to go back up because of a healing word.
And there's a dragon on the floor.
Mass healing word. One bonus action. Fourth level. So,
nobody's
everyone... everyone within the beacon takes 13 healing. Pretty much everyone who's hurt takes 13 healing. That would leave Will, who's outside the beacon and not hurt.
Oh yeah, I'm not hurt.
Benefits of being a rogue, man. Benefits of being a rogue.
I don't know. It's kind of iffy.
Okay, so. That your turn? Bonus action, your movement. Okay. It's the mage's turn. They're going to cast... 1 second. I believe it's called Ice Storm. Their last and only 5th level spell. I've just got to get up their sheets so I can actually roll it. Well, one of them's going to cast it. If I can find them. The other one's going to probably run away.
Can they please cast it on the dragon? They wouldn't, but I would love if they did.
Well, we'll have to see.
Oh, they're running. So they're leaving us with the dragon. They're leaving us with the dragon.
Mm-hmm. True.
They're basically just taking a pot shot just so that we suffer a little bit more.
Ray of Frost?
Okay. There's been a change of plan. But hey. So, instead they're going to cast Fireball. First one.
The question is where? Well, where can they see?
Let's see.
Can they see that spot?
If you want to hit me, just cast it so that it hits me.
Oh yeah, no, they're gonna hate you either way. But I just have to make sure who else they hit. Okay, right there.
But me and Will.
So
that, well, I guess that is.
That's. Okay. Yeah, that's what I was planning on doing.
That would hit Will too, so because if it casts there.
There's two fireballs on your way. So first is here. And second is here. Okay. It's the first one hitting the larger group. Yeah, also you not one.
Seven. Do even 7 plus.
Oh, I caught a nat 1.
I'm down again.
No, well, it's 14.
She nat 20. Okay. Something happened. I know. Wait, he can't? Oh, he doesn't. Dang.
Mm-hmm. Quad on that one. Everyone take the damage? Good, good. Second one. Yeah. So, think it hits a quad?
Is it dex save or?
Oh, okay, great.
Okay.
Another dex from me?
Oh, a nat 1. Oh.
Okay, hold on.
You said 29?
Oh! And I am down.
Can we just appreciate the fact that Sari just nat 20 3 times in a row? Yeah, true.
Is the quad down also? You guys better heal us.
Of course.
Yeah, the mages get the hell out of there. It would help if I didn't have the measuring tool out. Okay, so, Aturia, you're down.
Yep,
so
death save.
So, death save.
Nat 20. Hooray!
Hooray! You're prone, you have an action, and a bonus action.
Oh. Okay.
You have your move, yeah.
So that's my turn, though.
No, that's your turn. You can still take your turn.
Well,
you're on
okay.
1 hit point.
I'm gonna lay on hands myself. Sword all 45. Okay, and then I'm gonna go here. I'm gonna stand up. And I have a bonus action sword. Bonus action drink another healing potion. My greater health. Actually, just a regular healing potion.
Okay, so, Ren. Hi, Sev. What you doing? Thinking about eating some adventurers. They've been kind of toasted by two mages. They smell tasty. Oh, cool. Here's a question. Since it's liquid, do her legs turn to flippers? Okay, just making sure. So aquatic goes up by 7. Hang on. Oh wait, no. She went down, so her thing of her aura wouldn't be there.
My aura's back now.
Yeah. Okay. Who's next? Oh wait. They rolled a nat 1, didn't they? So it's now the dragon's turn.
He's not on the turn order.
Yeah, I know.
Oh wait, no, he isn't.
He isn't. Okay, one sec. I clicked the wrong button.
Goodness, for that nat
20 death save. This is just me moving it for something else. Never mind. Never mind the man behind the curtain.
You might just remove the bandits if they've already left.
Yep. Yeah. And meh. I did add it. One sec. There we go. And descend. There you go. That's better now, isn't it?
Yep.
So. First things first. I need to roll. Hi, Ross.
Hello.
That voice is buttery. Does not regain.
He doesn't get his Brett weapon back.
Yes.
Aww. But he does have a decent movement. So, look at Tasty Paladin!
Stomp, canned stomp, food.
Stomp that. Toasted canned food.
Do I get my. Or. Is it full arm?
And, can make three attacks.
Can it see me?
don't know. Do young dragons have that mind sense thing? I am. I'm going very easy.
No.
I mean, like, there is a trad. I mean, we could send in a trad and just watch him go to town while they stand there, like, nursing their wounds. There is another dragon about to eat Arturia, and it's not me. Senses are tingling, so, you know. He might know what's going on. If the particular DM wants to run him for a moment.
Oh, I'm here.
Oh, you've gotten into role.
Hence the whispers.
You've hence joined us. Hey man,
I'm waiting for those three attacks.
So, Trad.
Hello.
Do you want to make your grand entrance?
Oh, I do.
Okay. You're gonna have to wait,
going
clap.
To. Yeah, no,
you're
going
to have to wait
for frenzy, though.
Yeah, probably. Frotting at the mouth. Yeah, that means I get to bring in the other ones. Just so you know, Hey, Sev, do you want to be three of them? And I'll be three of them?
Oh.
Oh, look. Breakfast.
Could I see those?
Can they roll for initiative?
They've already did.
Take on the same initiative as this one.
Which is good.
That is true.
Hey, Seb, do you want to betray them and I'll betray them?
Wait, what?
No, okay.
He has to be Ren.
God damn it, I've got to use them all now. Oh well.
Can we,
panic? Yes, you can.
I'm not panicked.
Hmm. Oh, he would have gone. I know I'm gonna bring a buddy.
No.
Do you know who would have brought?
No.
Seth, you know how
to make. Let him bring a buddy.
Do you know how to make a grand entrance? You need a mighty steed.
No.
Oh. No. Okay.
See, I've already vetoed those too.
Okay. Sev? Oh, I was in the taps last time I was RPing Thrud.
Are you drunk?
Oh, no. No. You knocked on a door this morning.
Technically, you've been drinking with Ember this entire time.
I said he wasn't getting drunk. Deal with it.
You did say that.
So we have a drunken friend. Oh, she's already passed out face first on the table, snoring quite proudly and loudly.
So what is this about, Thrud?
Okay, I can live with that.
I'm waiting for your dragon's attack, so.
Mm-hmm. I've been putting this off for too long. I'm gonna have to attack Aturia, I'm sorry. Never get to do any fun stuff. You always get to ruin my fun.
Click.
That is true. Oh wait. Hang on, 10 feet range. I just gotta check something because. Oh, look at that! First bite attack. Oh, wait, she's down, isn't she? No, she's up at 7.
She's prone.
She's prone.
Act dead. Just act dead.
First bite attack is on Aquata. Sorry. And she's prone. And so that's a nat 20. So
just say she's dead. She's knocked out.
14.
It's just down.
30.
Doesn't matter. Yeah, you're just down. Oh no! Hold on. How much damage? There's 30. Aquata, what's your maximum hit points? Yeah. No, you're fine.
30. Yeah, you're fine. You're just down again. Sorry. And then two claw attacks on Aturia. 1, 2.
First one missed, second one hits me.
You may as well roll initiative, Thrud.
Okay, 12.
For 12.
Do I have a token? I don't have a token. Nice.
I don't know if that's where we're going to start out at. Yeah, just put us there out of the way.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And I roll terrible initiative.
It's Griffin!
Thanks. I recruited him.
Has Elaine met Griffin before?
No.
Okay, so she's just like, who are these guys?
No, you're not like anything, because you're unconscious.
Oh yeah, that's true.
Hi, Setsuna.
I thought their turn was over because you were being fair.
No, we aren't going right away.
They're not going right away. Dragon Slap will come in. So. Yeah, sorry about this, but. Bite. Does the bite hit?
No, it's not
in that one.
It's not one. Yeah. It headbutts the tree.
Thank you. Can it headbutt and then that's its turn? Because it now hit itself?
I'll apply the damage to it, but it's still got two claw attacks.
It's immune to poison, so it's 23.
I'm just glad at this point.
That moment Sev comes in and all my rolls start to go against me.
That's a 12 fail.
And 19.
I'm down.
11.
Hopefully you're still up.
I am down.
11 takes you down?
That is correct. I am down.
Okay, so there's all these other ones over here. Ooh, I'll move into position.
So this is what you guys said when they said that Epi was not.
Yeah.
When everything's trying to run away from you, they're running from something.
Yeah, we got that.
Yeah.
And, they somehow went into Dragon Valley. They looked at the map, like, are we lost? Nah.
Yeah, these two mages are dead. They don't see a chance, so I'm just moving them over here.
I think the bandit's dead, too.
Oh, no, he's still alive. He's crapping himself right now. Okay, so, Trad and Griffin have rolled initiative.
Yep, sadly not high.
I will reorganize the...
And Epi, since I saw them, you know what my resistance is.
Yeah, damage is fire. Poison.
And damage is fire.
Okay, so, Will, it is your turn.
Okay, so, I'm gonna go here. Wait, no. Actually, I'm going to roll stealth.
You move. You said you were going somewhere. Stealth is at disadvantage.
No, only if he moves over half his movement speed.
Mm-hmm. Okay, no. It's just I'm holding to you to what you say first. So
you know, I'm not even going to do that. I'm not even going to roll stealth. I'm just going to sprint. Go to
Lola. She was a choker.
I'm going to drop a potion in her.
Did you buy potions?
Yes. I bought 3 of them. One natural.
Yeah,
from the Erfin Grasp and Merlin's.
Yeah, it's good that I didn't update that thing because you guys saw us get extra potions this week. They were sold out.
Okay. I poured that in Liela. I'm going to... Lalea, okay. And
Did you roll for healing potion?
He did.
Yeah, I just did.
I got 7.
Okay, 7. Okay.
Then I'm gonna go here. And do I get advantage on shooting if
Archery is there? You used your action to give the healing potion.
Oh, I can't use my I can't use my cunning action. Okay, then I'm going to roll stealth.
You're using your cunning action to hide. But you can't hide from that dragon because you're in its face.
Are you hiding behind me?
That's fine if he wants to stand there. That's... Okay, so...
Yeah, I'm okay with this.
So,
can Griffin take a free action, please?
4?
Dragon 101?
They'll learn sooner or later, Sev.
But it's Griffin,
Lola,
this is his
Lila.
Thing.
When it's your turn.
Okay.
You're gonna go before him anyways, so...
I know, but it's too late at that point.
Yeah, I'm holding him to his movements. Okay. Lila,
yeah, so,
it's your turn.
Yeah, I know. I'm gonna stand up. And... I've already been stealthed, correct?
You were knocked out.
You were down. You can't be stealthy and unconscious at the same time. Well, no. Then again, you could be hidden by someone, so...
She could be in the trees. Would that be hidden?
She is the tree.
You could be unconscious and invisible. That's a horrible combination to be, believe me.
Right, so am I or am I not?
You're not stealth. You're just okay. There. You're also prone, so if you stand up, that's half your
movement. I already did.
Okay, so half your movement is gone.
Yeah,
Is Aquata down again?
Yeah.
Still down.
Yes. Down.
Yeah. But Throd and Griff are here. Mm.
She looks to the two that just arrived, and she's kind of like, help!
You can't see us, you're behind a tree.
Mm. So...
Alright, well, then I am stealthed.
No,
you're not.
You're stealthed to Griffin and Throd. The dragon can see you, so can't the two others on your right. Probably the three others on your
then,
right.
So...
There is no hiding from dragons. So, please, do your actions.
Right, okay, bam. Son of a bucket?
On which one? Okay.
Has that one been damaged beforehand?
No.
Okay, then I can't do that. Unless I can actually do, Slayer?
Nope.
No.
Okay, so yeah. That and a bonus action, I will neck.
Could you please roll damage?
Greater healing. There you go. And greater
sneak.
Healing.
Sneak.
I thought I wasn't stealthed.
Aturi is within 5 feet.
Alright, sneak. Okay. Then, I will, in that case, take a greater healing potion as a bonus and end my turn there.
Okay. So, it is now... I need a saving throw from Setsuna. Dex, please. You pass.
That is...
Yay.
That's a success. 10 and up is a success. Anything below, you would have been dead.
Yeah, I know.
Well,
that would be a failure. And 3 failures is death.
Yeah. Bandit proceeds to poop himself. Aquata, death saving throw.
Yay!
That's a success. Hi, Trad.
Hello.
There are green dragons. Your dragon senses are tingling.
Oh.
Yeah, the bottom one's tied.
Mm.
Because the other ones will have to come through Griffin.
Griffin, knowing Throd would see him, his eyes, his pupils dilate as Throd goes full rage mode. Double moves to pop up right here. And then we'll use his bonus action.
Was rage,
that's a good point. And then he will stand there and look at these dragons as he waits.
Standing between two dragons.
Eventually three.
Yeah. He's just going to take it all. Anyways.
And he's going to use his free action to taunt the bastards.
They kind of ignore you because...
Hey, he's calling their mothers very rude names in Draconic.
Can Griffin not take his free action?
Yeah, you can.
Back up, Brad.
Hmm?
In Draconic, he's like, I can't believe we said that about your mothers!
they respond with, we don't know who our mom is.
Exactly!
So, they don't know who it's now Griffin's turn.
Hi.
No, they don't.
So, here... And I'm in range.
Yay!
Hey, Epi.
Yeah, I know. I don't know what's coming, but I know it's gonna hurt.
So at advantage, that's a 27.
Oh, you're so glad you had advantage right now, Seth, aren't you?
I am, because there's going to be a jump on that one. So that's already 44 damage. And you know what? What happens when you crit?
You're not really rolling for a jump, are you?
Yeah, however, it does crit because it's maxed. It's damage dice. Okay. Once you hit a certain level, we maxed it out on this build only.
Okay.
So you would double it.
Just making sure.
Yep. Otherwise, it would not double, yes. Correct. And then, because I crit, there's a third attack. So.
Oh, God.
Hold on a second. Someone wait, no, but we're not done yet. We're not done.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure that young dragon is dead.
We love you, Griffin. We love you.
Arturia loves you.
Thrad, you've just been...
No. He says, no, sorry, Thrad. Thrad asked me to come because he has deep feelings of you. That's 187 points of damage.
Dead. You jump up, right? And as you come down... You come down with such force, the ground beneath the dragon actually craters. And its head flops to the side, and like poison just slowly seeps out.
He yells to Thrad, "That's one!" And then he looks very sternly at the group of you together, and he goes, "Seriously, did you not watch the cone breath? It would have killed you, all of you. Pick the cleric up and let's do this." And that's his turn.
So that's his turn. Turia, it's your turn.
Action. Give our cleric a healing potion. I only have regular ones left, sorry. And I rolled crap for it, but you get healed 4. Upon him.
4 is good enough.
Bonus action. I'm going to drink a Hill Giant's potion.
That leaves you with one remaining.
Yep.
By the way, can we all please take note of the Firefly who isn't here?
Hi, Firefly.
Okay, I only hear the captator.
Hello.
And did you move? Oh, it did. There, it's dead.
I turned it into a crater. Okay.
Yeah, you turned it into mush. It's mush.
And stand here. So that was my action, bonus action.
Okay.
That's it.
That's your action, your bonus action movement. Ren.
He's going to here in healing potion.
Okay.
I will roll it.
I am back to what I was before.
He goes... I get it. That's Ren's turn. He can't move anymore.
Okay. Make sure to take those healing potions.
Already did.
Awesome.
Wait, why did you do this? Why did you do this? I'm kidding.
So, it is now the green dragon's turn. Oh boy. Okay, hang on. I've got movement to do.
You have movement and breaths.
Yeah, lots of breath. Words. Sorry. Okay. So, Ren and Setsuna. I need con saves from you.
Okay. 10.
22.
The 10 fails. The 22 passes. Yeah, because it's going to be... One second.
Please tell me that con save mattered.
It would have had you had more hit points.
I figured.
However, at least you go back to 0-0 on death fails.
51, so half of 51 is... 25.
Okay.
Ren goes down. 1 point more than he had.
So okay. Am I.
So they're both down. Did they get their multi-attack after they use a Brett weapon?
Nope,
stuff?
It's their entire action.
Okay. So, Trad and Arturia, I need a con save from you two.
Ah, that wasn't as wonderful as I hoped it would.
You mean?
Yeah, plus four.
18.
18.
Oh, 18. 18, and yeah, you both pass, but you still take half damage. So half 46, 23.
Poison. Is that damage. From blue?
Yes.
I colored them up for you, Epi.
Thank you very much, Sev. And green starts to take out its multi attack. Sorry, Arturia, since you look slightly more squishy than the barbarian who's been taunting his mother. He makes a bite attack at you.
Fail. Is it at one. Advantage?
He's
not at advantage.
No, it's not at
no,
advantage.
No, he's out of range.
Nat one.
Yeah, he misses. And seriously, what is it with the bite attacks? What is it with bite? He misses. And that's as far as I'm doing it because of players telling me how to DM.
Oh, sorry.
And what is it with them not winning on bite attacks? Two claw attacks.
I don't know why.
It does. Two claw attacks on Trad.
The first one will hit, the second one will miss.
So 15 halved is...
Seven.
Barely a drop in the bucket, eh?
Huh. He just gave me a back rub.
Oh, I had an itch I need scratching. Okay, so... Hi, Arturia.
Hello.
Wait.
Are you really at 80 fly speed?
Can I ask about the bandit? Is he not going to do anything?
He's proceeding to crap himself and pray to his gods. He's weak prey. They typically leave someone alive. Green dragons. Very, very, very sadistic. So, gonna try bite attack on Arturia again.
16 meets. I'm down.
And, gonna say he probably has enough movement speed to get close to Trad again.
Oh, bring it.
They all just stand there punching Trad. And roll 20 is lagging. 1 second.
The 23 will hit. Surprising.
Did it roll twice? No, it didn't.
No. And a 23 will hit.
4, 12, 6. 6.
Are you half on each?
Yep.
So it's 9.
3 and 4, so it's 7.
Seven.
Oh, okay. And there's one more at the top, and he's going to start moving. Scroll.
Is that going to come all the way?
He could probably reach all the way.
Yeah. As he does, I will take my attack opportunity on him.
Yeah, I know.
For a 20, which I can spend a jump on. And he can back up 5 feet, Epi. Because he can't get closer. And red dragon. 44, 54, and 64 damage as he comes into my threat.
Okay, so options. He's gonna snap at you for that.
Yeah, hits. So
12,
5
piercing.
Poison, 17.
That's probably just a drop in the bucket for him too, eh?
There it is. I mean, it's more. I don't have quite the rod HP.
Or Perrin.
Perrin with his 300 and change.
Yeah. Will, it is your turn.
Okay, so I go over here. Do I have advantage if I strike at orange?
Because of the rod, yes.
Okay. A couple seconds, whoopsie.
Which means you've dropped your bow. You do not have
Yeah, I've dropped it. Okay, and green flame blade. Does this hit the orange?
1 second, I'm just checking.
Doesn't it have 16? Advantage?
It does.
Oh, yeah, 26.
That hits.
Like... That hits.
Okay. And for sneak it, do I get sneak attack because of that? Okay.
On the
orange. However, Peppers, just so you're aware, just because I know you're new playing this class, it would have been more advantageous to hit red because then you could have done bonus damage to blue.
Oh, good point.
But you already chose your target, so just so you know.
Okay.
What level is Will through?
Will is level 6 right now.
Okay, and how many levels of fighter does he have?
0.
Then why does he have a green flame blade?
Oh, he's an arcane trickster.
Can they take that?
There's nothing saying I can. Couldn't, I think.
I believe the only prerequisite that's a green flame blade is that you have to be an elf.
Or wizard.
I'm gonna go
No, it's... That. It's a cantrip, as far as I know. I don't think it's certain prerequisites.
Go ahead. Keep going.
Okay.
So, that's your turn?
No, I'm going to disengage and move my remaining movement. Oh, wait, no, here. There we go. Sorry. There we go.
Okay.
And then I end my turn.
Oh, yeah, because I built... The reason I was forgetting is because I built Roland before Sword Coast came out.
Start.
Yeah, and it's 3d6. It's not 66.
Okay.
His sneak attack's wrong.
Oh, wait. I did 66?
Yeah.
Oh, sorry, bud.
You need to change that. So
when did it get
you've been
to 66?
Doing way too much sneak attack
Oops.
Damage.
Oopsie.
So, Epi, it would have been 15.
Okay.
So add the extra 7 back to orange.
So, start.
Leia would probably, she would.
Panic? There's a load of dragons?
No, she is not panicking. She is a monster hunter. She kind of, dragons count. Dragons count.
Unroll 20 crash for me. 1 second.
Oh no! I'm sorry. Well, that'll give me a little bit more time to figure out what the balls I'm doing. Okay, I'm a...
I believe you're currently panicking.
No, I'm not panicking.
No pressure. Pressure.
Right, well, I'm gonna go over to behind Griffin, actually. I believe that's 35, and actually over here, that's it. And I'm gonna take a shot. Actually, hold up. Hold the phone. Where was I before?
You've already moved. Abby's been saying once you take your action, it's done.
Damn it. Alright, do I still get sneak?
On the one by, are you asking about the one by Griffin?
Yes.
Yes, he's within its
range. Alright. And it's taking damage, correct?
It has. It took a ton of damage.
Perfect.
Steph, could you minus the damage for me? Because...
Sure. I wasn't buying things.
17 hits, yes.
17 misses. They have an 18 AC.
It does.
Oh, son of a... So, none of that works.
Nope.
Well, you should
wait to see if you hit before you roll damage. Okay, I have no idea who's next because I'm still waiting
for Satsuna, death save. I got it. To your way you're reloading. Satsuna.
Thanks.
That is one failure. The bandit's gonna just take his opportunity and run like hell off the map.
The legacy of the brown streak continues.
Aquata, you are prone, however alive. Mass cure wounds, everyone within 60. So 26 to everyone. You have to actually 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Everyone to put me and Throd. Anything else you're doing? Tree. On who? Okay.
Interesting. Aquata is prone, isn't she? Not quite. Arturia and Aquata and Setsuna and Renu are prone, aren't they?
Yes.
Okie dokie.
I mean, you can hold till after Griffin. You know he's coming.
Throd will hold his turn until post Griffin.
Okay. She was staying. Okay, so you're gonna stay there? Alright, roger that. Throd holds it till after Griffin. The mages are all dead. Griffin is going to have to open a sheet for the young green dragons. And he's just gonna look at the rod. You ready for this? It's gonna be poisony.
You can just see Thrad's head tilt, just so you can see his jaw, and he just nods.
These are young. So, gonna make an attack at Griffin as on advantage. Not advantage, opportunity and miss. And then he comes here. Alright, so gonna start with orange then. And make all these attacks first, and then I'll go resolve them. 2. Let's see if I kill it. And one more jump. Can you add that up for me, Firefly? That's, you know. With the dragons, but without the crits, fires. And he'll have to make one more attack to kill it. Shit. He left it at 3 hit points throughout.
Oh dear, oh dear, oh dear.
Don't you have a bonus attack with
I was trying to get another bigger damage one. On another dragon.
You threaten all of those creatures, don't you, Griffin?
I threaten every one of them.
Oh yes.
You threaten their lives, their families,
their mothers.
And I look, just so you know, Abby, I look back at Purple and say, come on. That takes us to Throd.
Oh, who is going to absolutely lay into red? Red.
No, go green.
Go green?
You'll understand why.
Turns left to green. Realizing, of course, that's really the only choice.
You know that saying, it ain't easy being green.
3. So, I'm assuming the 14 and 16 won't hit.
The 16 doesn't hit, but the 29 and 23 do. So 60, 62 and 466 damage. It is still up.
Mm-hmm. Oh, if only I'd hit the third one as well. Shame. Which
wouldn't it
is his
it.
Turn. No.
Arturia, you're prone.
Hello, gets up half movement. I'll make two attacks against Creep.
Apparently, 21 will hit.
22?
Yep.
Is it still dead?
Oh, it's still up.
It's still up. Okay, another. Oh, yeah. Damn.
Miss.
See, I still have a bonus action, don't I?
You do.
Dang it, I should have smited earlier. Bonus action, drink the healing.
Okay, how many do you have left?
I have six total, so I'm gonna have five.
You drank in a couple of healing potions and given a couple out.
Yep, I've taken away every time I did that.
Okay. Are you back in, Epi?
I'm just getting sick.
Did anyone hear what he actually said?
No.
No.
There is also a question.
Arrow?
Eva, you drank a potion of strength, didn't you?
I did.
Did you... Because the on hit would increase, would it not?
It already
puts it in automatically.
Oh, okay, because you did up the strength on your sheet. Okay, cool.
It's because the Great Weapon Master, minus 5 and plus 5, essentially they zero each other out.
It's... Yeah, true.
Okay.
I'm back.
You're back, you got it?
Yep. So what does Ren do? Where from?
You death have save. No... Yeah, no, he doesn't have death save. Because my healing word.
You just have to get up, though, huh?
Yep, you are currently prone, Ren. Can't hear you if you are talking.
Is that better?
That is better.
Alrighty, so I gotta do the Epi thing and reconnect every now and then. Ren is going to go ahead and stand up, and which of the dragons is looking the worst at this point?
Green.
Alrighty.
That you can see is green for sure.
Okay, so I am going to go ahead and, during my time away, did I use any of my other?
You have no spells.
Okay,
you have none. You're. By the way, we're gonna talk about your sheet after.
I'm gonna go ahead and cast Eldritch Blast twice against green.
Okay. No idea. It's not because I can't. Oh, here we go. Wait, is that not one? That's not one.
Isn't that one?
Against green?
Yes.
Okay, roll me the damage on that one. 8 trad, you take 14 damage as you get hit the side of the face with an Eldritch Blast. And, 4 damage when it comes to Barbarian. Force damage is one of the few things of resistance to, or don't have resistance to. Second, you can roll the second one. Hang on, 1 second. What's that, They get moved.
It's a force knockback of 10 feet per shot.
He'd be knocking me into a dragon, which would not let me move.
Yeah, no, I'm just reading it, just to be sure.
I wouldn't do an attack of opportunity because it's against their will.
I know, I'm just reading it. So, is it a strength save or did it just get moved back?
It's just direct, no matter how big they are. Wonders of Telling Blast.
Does that... Hang on. No matter how big they are?
It can be a squirrel or it can be a full-sized dragon. It's going to get hit. It will get pushed back 10 feet.
That doesn't seem like... Invocation. ...possible.
They're only large, so it would work at least in this one.
Right. I know. It would, but something some creatures we can with their own strength. Yeah. So, there's back. Right here. Okay, so, what else are you doing? Is that your turn?
That is it.
Okay, so, their turn. This one is here. And it uses its bread attack finally. So I need a con save from.
Which color?
This one up here. Okay. Up the top, yeah.
It's Setsuna. And the ones in between. So it's Arturia, Thrad, Griffin, Setsuna.
Yeah. And not. Griffin, because Griffin has immunity to poison.
I do not have immunity. I have resistance.
Resistance.
Not quite that level yet. Getting there.
Getting there. So. I think Arturia is back down.
With a plus four.
37?
It's still. I'm still down. Even.
What's the DC?
It's 14. Last time I checked.
Okay. So. It's 15. 18. 18 for those who passed. And then it's 9 for Griffin. Because it gets quartered. As it steps in, it does not do anything yet. I take my. Yes, I do. I take my attack of opportunity. On it,
okay.
Master. And advantage because it of Thrawn.
Yeah.
That's a natural 20.
Nat 20.
Well, nat 19. It's the increased threat threshold. So,
it's a crit.
It looks really weak, right?
Yeah, it does.
I'm trying to think if I'm going to jump it or not. That's why I was wondering. I will not jump it.
Nah.
I'm gonna run the risk of not jumping it.
It's
because I
dead.
Don't have many left. 57, by the way, just in case it was close.
Yeah, it's well dead. You lop off its head. Its head rolls away.
He turns back to Thrawn. That's 2.
Technically, that's 3.
Oh, yeah, 3. Sorry, 3, Thrawn.
Thrawn, you're letting the side down. Okay, so now there's going to be. They looked at Griffin, they looked at the Trad, looked back at Griffin. They figure he's more squishy.
What, Griffin is? Griffin has higher AC.
Oh, then they look at Trad.
Trad, who's been nonplussed by the amount of attacks they dealt to him and damage they dealt.
It's like, it's a tough choice.
With advantage, because they have advantage, yes, no, and yes. Well,
yes, no, and
meet, but yeah.
Even with the shield thing?
Yeah, 19, it brings my AC to 19.
Yeah, when Griffin has a 20 standing, so.
So you take 15, half of 25. 14.
No.
So 5 and 7.
20.
It's 12, yeah, 12 and 8 is 20.
And then the next guy figures, fuck it. Setsuna.
Setsuna, did you take the...
Just one moment, guys.
Earlier 18?
as that claw hits Thrud, he gets to retaliate.
Oh yeah, there's that.
For a 30, so that'll probably hit.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure that hits.
For 34 damage.
It doesn't look very impressed.
Well, deal with it.
I mean, they look towards Griffin and they're slightly in awe. They look towards you and it's kind of like, meh.
Poor Thrud. Can't get respect from dragons.
Yeah, I mean, you're just like a castaway race that accidentally like came into being because of them.
I mean, they're all channeling their inner Arturi right now. Just trying to protest their love for him too much.
So, the one on the left, the red one, turns to Setsuna and makes a bite attack. Doesn't have advantage, does it? So a 13 hit?
It does, I think. No, it doesn't.
Advantage?
Nope, it does. Just based
on...
Yeah. I believe
he's
so,
pro?
Right? Yeah, because Aquatic healed him up before.
Okay, so he's prone, so it has advantage.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm just going to make the two claw attacks then, since I know
him. I could kill him. So do the bite first.
Yeah.
That knocks him out.
Oh. Sorry about that. My dog decided to go jump at a wall. Literally. That's the dragon's turn.
The bite knocks it out. You still have the two claws.
Oh, the two claws? Do they hit Griffin?
They both will, actually. An advantage. For 28.
Pretty decent damage. And that's their turn.
Brings us to Will.
Will.
Okay.
Will, what will you do?
I'm not going to save Arturia because that will put me in bigger danger. So I'm going to strike at green.
Green.
I mean red. Whoopsie. Oh, that tasted purple. Sorry. Why am I not moving?
Because you have the measuring tool up.
Oopsie. Okay. Then I'm going to green flame blade. Oh.
21.
Okay. Oh yeah, I have advantage. Oopsie. Then I am going to... Wait. Do I roll damage first or do I do my sneak attack?
You can do both. Doesn't matter. Order of operations doesn't matter.
I'd roll damage first.
Oh crap, that's not what I meant to do.
Good.
So 5 plus 10 on the other one.
Mm-hmm.
13, so 18. Okay.
Then I'm going to disengage and move by Setsuna. Oh, no.
Too late.
I meant to say
no.
Here.
Too late.
Oh, too late. Okay. Okay.
Then it's your turn. Sorry.
Right. Well, I wouldn't get advantage on the purple now that Archer is down. So, I would get advantage on red. So, I'm gonna move there.
You don't
there.
Get advantage on either.
Why? I mean, for, like, sneak attack. I meant to say sneak, not advantage. I wouldn't get it on purple, correct? Because Archer is down.
Correct. Unless you go into the trees and attempt to hide.
Well, I'm actually going to save that for the end of my turn. So yeah, I'm going to take a few shots well, one shot Red. Hit. Yep. And because that sneak and Colossus and Mamba. There we go. And then as bonus action at the end of that, I'm a hide. Because.
See, now I have a question, Seth.
This or not.
You or not. Kind of gonna hide.
Or not.
Just out of curiosity, they all turn and look at you. And the only look in their eyes is, dinner. So, Seth. Blind sense? When they roll stealth to hide in a tree, wouldn't they just know?
If they're within the blind sense range, yes.
Okay, just making sure.
The other thing I gotta remind you of is you need to roll three separate d6s.
I know.
From last turn, you forgot to.
Oh, awesome. And it is now...
So roll him now.
Sets in his turn. I'll do that while he's rolling again.
Death saves Setsuna.
He said he's making some food. He hasn't notified us of returning yet.
I'll just roll him now.
Oh, there he is.
That's two failures.
That one.
And that's no recharges. God damn it. Oh wow, two failure. Did he already have one failure? No, he had one success.
He got brought back up, so it's 0-0.
Yeah.
Otherwise, he'd be dead right now.
Bandit isn't here anymore. Quada, you up?
She'll be right back. She said if she mass healing word level 3, sacred.
I will get it right now. I'm opening your sheet up here. So 9 to Setsuna, Will, Ren, Arturia, and then I'll be Griffin and Throd, based on danger.
I have a question, sir. Boy, that's healing more.
Yep, 60 feet.
No, I was going to say mass. Do you need to see them?
No. It's within the range. And she can technically see everyone. If the tree trunk is these two, then
yeah.
I could have
just I'm just making sure.
Based on the situation, I know she said something else, but I'm going based off what her spells look like. She's going to focus it here, and she'll be able to hit all these people and herself. Hold on. 1, 2, 3... 4, 5, 6. Nope, all these people. She's gonna mass heal. Mass cure wounds. For last 5th level. So another 24 to those people. And then she's going to kind of step back there. Try to distance herself. So 24 to Arturia, Throd, Setsuna, Will, and Ren.
Okay, he said 32?
In total, Griffin gets it, yeah. It's a total of 33 points of healing.
Okay.
So if you're at 0, you go to 33. And that is her turn.
Griffin.
We're going to start with Red. And I'm going to change which view I'm on. Because I only did that because I'm sure I want to start with red.
Because you could start with purple.
I could go up there and start with purple. The difference is here, Abby. There's a cluster again.
And he told us not to send a cluster earlier.
So at advantage.
Spawn spore.
24 and a 26. I'm gonna jump on the second one because I don't think I'm gonna do enough to kill it otherwise. And that will leave me with one jump remaining, Epi.
Okay. Firefly, you rock.
I got you.
If you're here. 22. It's 7. Every time I see that, all I can take
87
is
87 damage.
Shoot. Yeah, it's down.
Or 109. 109, no, I forget the jump. So it's down. Which means I get my bonus action as a regular attack on blue. And I'm jumping just to give Grodd a chance to kill it easily. And 18 just meets. So there's the last jump I have, period. For the day.
45.
I get it.
18 is 73 plus 4. There you go.
67.
It is still up.
Wonderful.
And I will actually step there. Yes, I will step there. I'm still in its range, as it is in.
Yeah.
Ah.
So. Surprise. May he actually get a kill count?
I may actually get a kill for once.
I'm gonna say, I think we've hit this thing pretty hard. I would go by hit, bro.
Yeah. 38. Pardon?
Oh, damage, yeah, it's dead.
After that then, Thrud will move his movement to stand next to Arturia, just there.
I'm actually laying on the ground.
Yeah, you are. That's why but I stepped up.
Yeah, Griffin right, is still providing threat.
Yep.
One and two. That second one wouldn't hit, I'm still at advantage, so it's not on that one.
Thankfully.
Yeah.
Would you have hit me if it yep. was?
Yeah.
33. 33? So damage or?
Damage.
Yep.
Yeah, it's not looking healthy.
Yes!
And that's Thrud.
That's Thrud?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so let's have a look. Whose turn is it now?
Arturia.
It's Arturia's.
I'm gonna get up. And I'm gonna attack it twice. And divine smite at the highest level.
Okay, roll me your attack.
What's attack? 21.
Divine smite. That hits. Roll me your divine smite.
Thirty-six.
Still up?
Yep.
Okay, second attack. 29.
Just roll damage.
That hits. Just roll damage. It's
again.
Dead.
It's not dead. Okay, it's dead. Okay, good. Yes, I killed something!
I'm lagging right now.
Then she's gonna look between Thrud and Griffin and go, why are you guys here?
Thrud said that if you died, you couldn't cook him dinner.
Want that damn food.
Griffin sits down on a dragon and dragons.
Thrud points at Griffin and goes, that's a very good point. I have a bag of holding on me, Griffin.
Ah, they're youngs though. They won't make anything really good.
They won't make anything? And then, mm-hmm.
Then you would not call it a worthy trophy, then.
Griffin looks to her, pulls like goes into his bag of holding, pulls out like this long, basically whole arm sized tooth, and someone's blowing out my eardrums. And just like, no, this might be them.
She's gonna go. Can I at least collect some of the poison from them? Do they like secretiate poison?
They don't have a gland.
Dang it.
Well,
it's a good idea though.
It was a very worthy hunt. Did anyone get her up?
Is Sasuna still down? No, Sasuna's up. Aquata mask her.
Okay, because I saw the thing and I was like, ooh, what? Okay. So, yeah, she would get as much meat from the dragons as she could carry and sell it to...
So, roll survival.
On it.
Oh, crap, I can make clothing out of this.
Would it be bad if I cooked you some of this dragon meat?
Could I roll a survival as well? Because I need some of that. I might be able to make some boots.
Yeah, you roll survival.
Okay. Oh, great. Yeah, survival's so not one of my stats. Okay.
She would do that so she could sell it to Butch.
Knowing what you know, Peppers, going freely, right, on this, knowing what you know about making clothes and boots and stuff like that, as you get this, it's not good enough. You won't be satisfied with the product you'd make out of it.
Satsuna just kind of walks up there going, I think we know why they were running.
Okay, then I go to Leela and I try to buy the leather. I mean, buy whatever she collected.
She took meat, no leather.
Aw. Well,
you could ask someone.
I mean, I could roll again to help.
You get one roll, dear.
Alright. I'm gonna sell that meat to Butch, by the way.
I'm gonna take some of this meat because this is what I'm feeding Drad later.
Yeah, because you're dating Drad.
Not dating.
Yep.
I'm Griff, like, does what? Does Griff and Sama's here?
Only when Griffin's there, huh?
Does it count as cannibalism if Trad eats another dragon?
No, because he's not actually a dragon.
Okay, just making sure.
So do I get some meat then out of this green young green dragon?
Yeah, you get some meat.
Can I get some skin too?
Nope, you asked for meat.
Can I get some teeth?
You get one roll.
Dang it, okay, I'll just take some meat then.
Thrad took a head. So Does Will ask Griffin to cut him off some meat?
Will, or could you leather? Like, will you...
I know where that head is going. Grunt's gonna wake up and it's gonna be staring him in the face and he's gonna have to either headbutt it or roll.
Yes, I will ask Griffin if he could, get me some skin.
Abby, because dragon is at advantage.
Yeah, I know.
Oh, no, I get nothing. I rolled double twos.
Oh, you poor thing.
I'm sorry.
Griffin is...
This is a fashion nightmare!
Can I take a liability with this, Sev?
Sure.
Griffin is watching, too busy watching Trad and Arturia. Trad? Going, they make a good couple.
Trad offered to play catch with Griffin with the dragon head.
Yeah.
But ignored.
No, I'm offering because I watched Will butcher dragon skin, so he's trying to be nice.
Mm.
And then roll double twos.
So you butchered them too?
Yeah.
Oh, sorry. This would have made such beautiful boots.
However, he goes, you know, I'm sorry, but do you like my handiwork? And it says Thrad X Arturia in the skin.
I just smile and nod.
Gonna turn to Griffin and says, so.
Guys, don't ignore Fallen's roll. 19 on run.
Yeah, he absolutely gets mine.
What does it mean?
It means it seems like you're courting Thrad.
Stares at the writing. It's literally, I wouldn't say the writing on the wall, but it's... You know?
It's the writing on the dead dragon's flesh.
What if she says, but I...
I wonder if dragon flesh can make a good wall. That's pretty freaky.
It would rush.
So, my character would want to know why there were so many dragons. Is there a way to roll if she finds something like that might give her a clue?
He looks at all the dead bodies. I mean, Gribben would make an assumption here. It's not canon.
Sure.
He looks at all the dead bodies of weak individuals and goes, because you stumbled upon their hunting game. These are children. Bosh of the dragons. And they like to toy with their food. You took away their game.
Oh.
That makes
generally
a lot.
Pissing them off.
Griffin, how far can young dragon go in a day? The green ones.
Looks them over. Basically, by foot, me or you on a normal march can make it about 25 miles in a day, right? If they are flying, depending on the weather, you're talking 150, 200 miles, maybe? If they're not pushing themselves? If they're pushing themselves, 400 miles.
Actually, there might be a nest somewhere.
Oh, there's definitely a nest somewhere.
Well, if you manage to find it, may I join you?
Should we be worried about the nest?
He looks at the six dead young children. Yes, you probably should. He's like, he points the six corpses. You killed someone's clutch.
Someone's gotta be mad.
Someone much older and bigger.
No, ancient dragons are a bastard.
Oh. Are they going to be looking for us now? And how good would they be at tracking us?
Are you an elf?
Griffin looks at Setsuna, deadpanned, and goes, seeing that they can take the form of, well, you or I, and walk into the city to find you, yes, you probably should.
How fun.
Well,
so, Dragon Slayer, what do you recommend?
They fly. Pray. The ocean wouldn't save you.
He says pray, puts his glaive away, and starts walking towards the city.
Wait, you didn't answer my question.
What was the question?
Does this mean it's over between us, Griffin?
He looks back and goes, dear, we weren't dating.
I know, but...
How can it be over if it never began?
Our tear is going to run away now.
It'd be unwise to run from the group. When we're being
hunted. Yes.
I wish I had an apple to eat. Popcorn.
He's not saying you were over. I mean, he's just saying we never were dating, so if you went on a date with Throd, that doesn't upset him.
And equally, we're not necessarily being hunted now, because the other dragons have no idea that their friends have died, or their clutch has died. So,
good chance to get out of here soon.
Yes, which is why lingering here and chatting is possibly not the smartest idea.
Indeed.
Follows Griffin as he walks away.
I'm gonna stand here shocked for a bit.
Nope.
Throd, can you pick her up and bring her with us?
Yep, don't try to check.
Wait, what can I do, contestant?
Oh, please, contest.
Athletics or acrobatics?
Athletics.
Straight strength.
You are at advantage still, G2. Well, second would be raging.
Equally, Sev, you remember what level of barbarian I am?
Yep.
Yep.
He automatically passes.
Yeah, I rolled my minimum value as well.
I was close, okay.
27.
He just picks you up over his shoulder.
Bag of potatoes. And you roll athletics.
Lilith just chuckles.
I'm going to skip that figuring experience.
Yeah, we'll do that in a second here. But for now, we make our way back. So we will say goodbye to Twitch for now.
Later, Twitch.
Bye, Twitch.
Bye, Twitch.
Bye, Twitch.